social distancing lazima. Tasha is just like cool.
Yeah.
Welcome to Y254.
Thank you so much.
So tell us just a little kidogo to watch out to a jewel who Icelander is and you know what you're all about before we can get into details of how you've been doing and all the things that you've achieved.
Sure thing. Icelander is upcoming Kenyan rap and producer.
I'm You're going to call yourself out. Upcoming?
No,
upcoming.
Yeah, I'm upcoming.
Really?
Not many people know me yet.
Yeah.
I mean, just because I've done a record with Sean Kingston, you know, I'm just starting out. Not many people know me yet. So I think I'm upcoming, I think.
Okay, you know what? We can agree to disagree, you know? But I think the fact that first you're very humble, you're downplaying yourself, your track, There is one track that you've toured, and I think it's the one with Sean Kingston, man.
Okay.
That is on another level. You can't just say you're upcoming when you do such a track.
I'm an upcoming good artist.
Yeah, I like that. Yeah. Upcoming good artist. Guys, we're going to be showing you that song in a bit, but before we go there, how long have you been in the industry for you to call yourself upcoming? Umeanza juzi ama?
Okay, it's been a while, but, you know, professionally, as Icelander, it has been like 2 years.
Yeah.
Yeah, so professionally I still under 2 years, but I've been in bands, I've been in groups before.
Really?
So
by bands you mean? Like, you know?
Yeah, bands, you know, I've played in bands before. You know, I was singing before I started rapping, you know, in high school. Then I joined some other bands before I decided, okay, I want to do, you know, hip-hop.
Yeah, do you know when somebody tells me they've been in a band, I'm just like, whoa, mad respect. Because you have to have a band, you're on another level. Because anyway, you can't just take a mic and start singing, to be honest,
not in
a band.
Yeah.
Guys will boo you.
Yeah.
You know, like, for you to be in a band, that means you're very extremely talented.
Yeah.
And I think that's why I think you've gone to those levels of working with big artists. And we can't wait to see who else you're going to work with.
Yeah.
So I know, kama kawaida, our interviews are usually very quick because of curfew. We know by 9, especially when an artist comes to the studio, we have to do things really fast so we can let them go. Because I know you're trying to keep safe, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Let's go straight to it. Mm-hmm. Before, there's a song you've done before, the one you've done with Sean Kingston, or is it vice versa?
Yeah, I did one last year.
Elevate?
I think two tracks. Yeah, Elevate.
Yes.
And there's another one called Way Up.
Yeah.
I didn't shoot a video for that one.
Yeah.
I think that's... Way Up is actually the song that really blew Sean Kingston's mind and wanted to work with me.
Yeah.
It's not on YouTube, but I think I'm going to like put it on YouTube. It's on Apple Music and other platforms. Yeah.
No, you should, you should.
Yeah.
So, out of curiosity, I want to know, how did it come to, you know, that you had to work with Sean Kingston? Like, I mean, let me stop guessing. I was just about to start like, so why are you just chilling and you dropped that, you know, slide into my DMs like, yo, can we collab? You know?
Yeah.
How did it come to pass that you guys work together?
Yeah, Sean Kingston is big. He's a multi-platinum selling artist. It's not easy to work with someone like that. Even people like Calligraph, it's not easy.
Yeah.
So you can imagine how hard it is to get to Sean. So Sean was through his manager. His manager is actually a producer. And there is this platform called Beatstars where producers and rappers can find beats. So I use it a lot to find beats. So that's how I got connected with this manager. His name is Kilo. So, you know, I started, you know, buying his beats. At the time, I did not know he was his manager.
Yeah.
So until one day he posted a picture of him with Sean Kingston and I was like, you know this guy? And he's like, I'm his manager. So I told him I want to work with
him. Did you even believe him first? You were like,
yeah.
You know, you're like,
I had to do a Google search, you know? Yeah, so I saw some of his interviews talking of, you know, managing Sean Kingston. That way I believed him.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then you were like, yo, how about your boy?
Yeah.
Like, I need. So is it, did you produce a track? Or at the time that produced the track and then you worked? You worked on it. Like, how did it work?
So it was produced again by another producer I met on Beatstars. He's based in the UK.
Oh, wow.
He's really talented. His name is Blank Beats. So, you know, the song, I had done it on my own. Then I sent it to now his manager, and he sent it to Sean, and Sean loved what I did. So that way he decided to hop on the track.
Like, I'm just like, us guys are here struggling. We're like, you, Tiesto, where are you? I'd like to work with you for the next Tomorrowland. These dudes don't even respond, Mazi.
They never respond.
You know, for you, I mean, to get to Sean Kingston, that's a, I mean, that's a big step. So for the video that you guys, you've done the video, right?
The plan was to do the video in April.
But then COVID.
COVID came, you know, everything was set up in Miami.
Yeah.
I had to go over there and do the video. You know, one thing is that Options is not the only track I've done with Sean Kingston. I've done up to 5 songs with Sean Kingston. So he was like, you know, we cannot wait. Let's just put it out, you know, start promoting it.
Yeah.
Since we've done like 5 tracks, once COVID ends, you know, you come to Miami, we do videos, then, you know, we go ahead.
So we're going to play it just like that, you know, cool. So Sean Kingston told me, like, you know, let's do 5 tracks and, you know, go to Miami.
Yeah, Miami.
Miami,
yeah.
You know, let's just go to Miami and drop this shoot, you know. That's a big deal. Like,
it's a really big deal.
Yeah. And I think, so are you considering yourself pushing your music towards, you know, the States, or you want to still go with the Kenyan sound and, you know, push it, you know, you'll be able to say, it all starts back here. But also, if you have an opportunity to start your music out there, I mean, why not? Like, what's your plan like?
You know, every artist would love to have a fan base all over the world.
Absolutely.
Every artist, you know, if you have fans in Latvia, in Azerbaijan, you would appreciate that. So for me, anywhere is okay. I'm okay with building a fan base over here, building in the US, UK, you know, Zambia, whatever. So that's the plan. You know, the thing is that if you get an opportunity like this one, you have to take it. You never know when something like that is going to come again. So I had to take it, you know.
Yeah. I like that. We're going to be playing your song.